Now stay tuned after the game on Ducks Live with Brian Hayward and Jenny Kavnar. The Ducks players will give the jerseys off their backs to their adoring fans. And of course, we'll hear from Teemu Selanne, whom they are cheering right now in the building because they've shown a picture of him on the Diamond Vision above center ice. All that and more coming up on Ducks Live immediately following the conclusion of this, the final home game of the season at Honda Center.
They are standing and they are cheering. And why wouldn't they be? I mean, Teemu Selanne just had a big old grin on his face. And you know what? The linesman's taking his time to drop this puck. And it's a wonderful
very
tribute.
Respectful.
Yep. Wonderful tribute.
Sometimes the crowd dictates. And that's what's going on right now at Honda Center. Let's listen. Were it not for the tap on the backside from Teemu Selanne, I don't know how much longer Nansen would have waited to drop that puck. Loose puck to Teemu on the near boards, tries to move it into the middle. Nugent Hopkins collects it. He's tripped up by Fowler, and the Oilers are going to get their first power play of the game with just 4:39 to play. And the game be damned right now. The crowd not even responding to the penalty call. They're just chanting one more year to Teemu Selanne.
Yeah, Cam Fowler reaches and inadvertently upends the Oiler forward. And boy, Teemu Selanne will head back to the Anaheim bench. You mentioned, John, the first Oiler power play of the game. Anaheim has had 7 minutes and 30.
Just 5 seconds left. Selanne at center might have time for a shot. Goes wide, shoots as the horn sounds, and Dubnyk makes one last save.
What a burst of speed from Teemu Selanne. Seconds were left. When he released that shot, there was time on the clock, and Dubnyk, you're right, makes one last stop against Teemu Selanne. Man, was he flying.
I didn't think he had time to get a shot away, but he showed us at 41 he still has the speed to make time.
Well, the Ducks, you know, this was a hard luck loss. It was not for lack of trying. They dominated from the 10-minute mark of the opening period. It was all Anaheim tonight, but they've just gone cold offensively. They generated so many quality chances tonight against Devan Dubnyk. They just couldn't find a way to beat the Oiler netminder. He was sensational, absolutely sensational in this game.
Well, they lose only 5 times in regulation in their last 21 home games. Unfortunately, the fifth one is here tonight to the Edmonton Oilers by a final score of 2-1 as they salute their fans at center ice and head into the locker room. The final home game of the 2011-2012 season in the books. The Oilers get the win by a final score of 2-1. They'll head into the locker room and make their way back out onto the ice surface in a matter of moments as they will give the fans the jerseys off their backs, all part of the Fan Appreciation Night celebration that remains ongoing here at Honda Center.
You know, they wanted this one so bad, Johnny. You know, I thought they were in shock the way that this game started for them tonight. But to their credit, you know, they collected themselves. They played a whale of a hockey game after the Oilers took that 2-0 lead. Pretty amazing, quite honestly, that they could not get that second goal against Dubnyk because, boy, they had them dead to rights so many times.
Well, Edmonton gets a pair of goals in the first 6:04, and they make it stand up. And one last time, at least for this season, Teemu Selanne is honored as one of the stars of the game in the building.
And all we can hope for right now is that there is one more year for Teemu Selanne. And based on performance, and nothing but performance, if you take the emotion out of it, you would have to say, how could there possibly not be another season? He still leads this team in scoring. Still the face of the franchise, and still, as we saw in that last shift, tremendous juice left in those legs.
And he still has time for
Ken thank Rich. You standing by with Teemu Selanne. And Teemu, you've been hearing it all night long. Fans, I'm sure, have something they want to say to you. When you hear the fans say this, you hear their reaction, you see the signs, does it make you think about coming back for one more year?
Oh, absolutely. I think, you know, there's still a lot of passion and excitement for the game for me. But same hand, you know, there's so much work, and I have to start thinking about, you know, future also, and gotta end somewhere. But obviously, so far it has been unbelievable, and so happy, and so so lucky that I've been able to play in front of these great fans, and it's unbelievable.
Teemu, why do you think you have the connection with these fans the way you do over the years, especially here at Honda Center?
Well, our fans, they have been so supportive, and I've always have a great relationship with the fans, and they give so much energy and passion for our game, so I'm very thankful.
You didn't have the start that you wanted, but from January 1 on, this team has showed a different fight, a different brand of hockey. What changed?
Well, obviously, everybody start doing their own jobs, and we start playing like a team. And the second half was so good, and I think everybody really enjoyed to play again. And too bad the first half was so bad, but this team is going to have a great, bright future here, and in front of the great fans here. So it's going to be awesome.
And I'm sure we don't want to say never, Teemu, but is there one thing that you want to say to these fans here tonight?
Well, obviously, I've always have an unbelievable relationship with the fans, and they have really made this home for me and my family, and it's just an honor to play so many games in front of these great fans, and I just want to say thank you. Thank you.
Teemu Selänne, number one star of the game, team. Thank you very much. Ducks lose it 2-1, but Teemu Selänne taking center stage. Don't go anywhere, everybody, because Ducks Live starts right now with Jenny Kavner.